I really identify so much with Jabba the Hutt. No, I'm kidding. Actually,
welcome, originals, to the Outer Rim. I'm George Hammer, and this is the Content Cantina, the place where we proudly show our scars. Why do you think all brands want to be heroes?
Well, the more heroic of the brand is, the more stuff it sells. The thing is that in all great storytelling for all time, the hero requires flaws and requires challenges and conflicts to overcome for the story to be interesting. This is why we should almost embrace our faults. When a brand is in crisis, that may not be the time to play up conflict, drama, struggle. You have to do almost a Jimmy Swaggart apology. I'm so sorry, we messed up, but look at what we're doing to fix it.
I should have bought you flowers and held your hand.
When things are going really great is when you might want to start looking for conflict, drama, struggle.
Yeah, and if a brand shares that, they evolve from being a brand character to almost like a human character.
Right. It's kind of cool to think about brands as if they were a person you knew. I want to be sold to by people that you want to have a drink in the Star Wars cantina with.
Good morning, everybody.
No matter how freaky they are.
What can a brand learn from a news network in the way they tell stories?
Because I'm not here to be your buddy. I'm here to swallow gum. And I'm here to take names.
A war room is reactive, right. and it's responding to crisis. And if you do a better job of putting out your own story, more of your own original content that sets the agenda for what your company's about and for the latest crusade you're doing in whatever area, then you're kind of filling that vacuum and you're creating the story first.
Yeah, and one of the things that I think we do not need to copy is talking heads at a desk.
You mean like what we're doing now?